And this is our second attempt of a live Q&A for about the Harmony Sound Therapy Practitioner Training, which will happen from an amazing place, which is the Holistic Gardens. So the place from Eva's heart, yes. And her husband and her family. And this is our second attempt of the video. And funny enough, we encounter sound problems on the previous video, talking about sound and talking about sound therapy and how sound therapy is beneficial for you and everything. And absolutely it is. And the sound is a way we can remove the obstacles on our path, mm-hmm. and we can remove obstacles in our body, in our mind, in our emotions, in our energies, and also in our spirit, mm-hmm. As well. And here, before we go into a conversation and questions you might be having, anything of that sort, I would love to introduce you to Eva.
Hello everybody, nice to see you. Thanks for coming to see us.
And to her amazing gift, which is the voice and singing, and it is chanting mantras. Mm-hmm. And this is how we started our journey, and this is how we've met, and this is how we danced and chanted, and this is how we are here now, offering this beautiful gift to you. So, Eva.
Thank you, Camilla. So for those of you who are familiar with mantra, join in. Camilla is going to join in, I think. So we'll invoke Lord Ganesh. And funnily enough, Lord Ganesh celebrates his birthday tomorrow. And the mantra that I'll sing now, after a couple of moments to just open up the energy in the Holistic Gardens and inaugurate the course, the sound healing course with Camilla, is Om Gam Ganapate Namaha. So it's a very, very powerful mantra for anybody, for everybody, and not just anybody, everybody who would like to remove an obstacle. Like we just said, we had a few obstacles, and that's just fun and games, but it always reminds us that we can use our power, our sound, to touch what we can't see, to feel what we can't hear, and just to be so present in our mind, our body, and our soul all at one time. So I'll invite you now to, wherever you're sitting, wherever you are, even if it's at your desk, if it's on your couch, just take a few seconds and come into your body. And come into this time and just take a breath and allow that breath to travel wherever it is. No judgment, not anywhere, not deep or anything like that, just wherever it lands. Allow your broad body to really connect with where you are now and with us, because we'll bring this space to you. And on the next breath, I'm going to start with three ohms, and then we'll get into Om Gam Ganapate Namaha. So,
oh.
everybody. Thanks, Camilla.
So, beautiful. So, I hope you really enjoyed this vibration. And yes, so this is one part of using the sound, and everyone will connect with the sound in a different way. And also the sound of our own voice. For some people, there will be mantras coming from an Indian Hindu tradition. For other people, it will be Celtic music. For other people, like me as well, it will be Slavic influences or Latin American music as well. And it is about finding our own note and the note of our soul, and something would resonate with us. And this is what this course is about, is about taking the time for yourself, really allowing yourself the 9 months of the journey and exploration of your own vibration, of your own note, of your own frequency, the one you came here to resonate with in the world, the most healthy, potent, vibrant, and creative as well. So for that, the sound comes so handy, and we can use the sound in many different ways.
Yeah.
And we can use the singing bowl, so there will be the instruments you will be wearing. So metal singing bowls, beautiful instruments. Many different instruments, so they are koshis, they are Himalayan chimes, so this is something to suit your body and suit your soul. And it is about really picking an instrument you resonate with and starting to play and starting to explore the frequencies and how it affects your body, and also how it affects the body of another person. And how you can use all those beautiful tools to help other person, to help yourself first and other people around you too. So you will, at the end of the course, be very skilled with using various healing instruments. So metal balls, crystal balls, gongs, drums, tuning forks, and you'll be learning about playing them off the body, around the body, and also on the body.
Mm-hmm.
So those tools are there available for us, for each of us, and once we learn how to use them, we can use them to get in tune. And this is something a little bit material, something what we can hold, what we can use, we can play, to remind us that we can always come back to balance, and we can always come back to our center. And this center can happen in this beautiful center in the holistic gardens. And here again, I would love to bring this land into the picture as well. And would you like to talk a little bit about the place?
Sure. So the Holistic Gardens is a labor of love, and it certainly has left its mark on our hearts and other people's hearts. So the building of what I would call, it's a womb-like space, and I've said this already, but when you mentioned a 9-month course, the allowance of something totally new in you to come like a butterfly, you know, to metamorphosize, the potential of doing that in a safe space and being held by somebody who can offer those assurances that everybody, it's open for everybody, and it's yes to everybody. Because we certainly here know the building, and love the building. And I hope that transmits over the airwaves. But one of the things we found, the building created, every time something flowed, something lovely appeared and flowered. And we certainly never thought, when we began, and Sarah is my husband, and our family, and all the workers and everybody that was involved, because it certainly was a team effort. And you know, it takes a community to rear a child. It takes a lot of people to come up with a space. So when I met Camilla, and she spoke so passionately from her heart about her vision of sound, I just felt immediately connected, because she was coming from that space. And the excitement of wanting to be part of that, when Camilla was introducing it to me first, it was Dublin. And now I'm being very good and sitting very steady in this chair, but I can't wait. And it's a blessing. And it's a blessing for this kind of place, because people who show up here, I feel, are, you know, we're all called on different frequencies, and you might hear that sound, but it's certainly a vibration. So it's so lovely to see the space being worked and lived in finally after such a long time, because we're closed for such a long time. But show us what she wants us to come in. So everybody's
she
so
meaning
well.
The land and the building.
Yeah,
she is a box.
But yes, it's so exciting and it's so fresh.
Mm-hmm.
Because fresh, and I don't mean just because of the times that we're in, but fresh because I'm at an age where I caught learning an instrument, or even allowing you to video me last week.
We made a huge progress here, guys, from a first live video and live performance and like singing and dancing, to a week later going into a full-blown interview.
Yeah.
On social media. So it's a big step.
Yeah, and that is exactly, it's exciting, and it's just beyond what, I don't know what to expect, but I feel safe. And I feel safe because obviously I know where I am, but I feel safe because you are inspired by where you are too. So that can only work as a combination. And teamwork for me is huge. And to be here with different instruments, different sounds, the room, Camilla, and all the other people who I'm sure are going to make this, whatever it's going to be, it's very exciting, and we're delighted that we'll get to do that here in the Holistic Gardens. It's really amazing.
Delighted. Yeah. And especially, this is like a very important element, that it's being born and alive at this time. We are actually living on the planet, so at this time when we collectively go through a very massive transition and global crisis in many places in the world, and also a huge challenge within us, because like everything we know and we knew is actually falling apart and changing at a very fast speed. So the sound is amazing, and it can help us to clear the blockages, make space. Sound is space, it's nothing mm-hmm. else but space. It's the sound of our breath first, and then everything else follows, and everything we can hold, we can strike, we can use the magic wand and beat the ball, tap the ball. It's only a bonus and a little place where we can really use our body, use this instrument to be able to explore, get excited, go into the unknown. We don't know the sounds, it's like, oh, it doesn't sink. Matter. Resonance, dissonance, harmony is all there to be explored. And there is, so this training in this magical place is literally like my dream coming true. And Because everything I see here, not only this space which you see here, it's like outside there are donkeys and mama donkeys and llamas and dogs and cats and children and everything and beautiful, beautiful land. It's like the breath of Cavan surrounding the space in their green, magnificent drums.
Yeah.
Types of the space, that's what they call it.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
It's all around. So it is like a womb of a land. So this is like one of this like really serene experiences. But also the course will happen in Dublin. And in fact, this, what you experience, is like all the sounds are welcome. Absolutely every single sound. And even here, really just being here so spontaneously and working for the last few days with a little recording of the online version of the course, because the course will go to everybody who cannot come here as well. It's like we don't have many spaces because we will respect the regulations and the government regulations. So there is only 10 places available in this live course and in this space this year. Yet there will be also another course which will go online and it will be recorded here. So this energy, this sound, this vibration will travel everywhere.
Yeah.
And this is actually also your kindness to really, without knowing me, with like singing a mantra and dancing and spending like 2 hours together a week ago, be here today, you know, like a week later and really just offering this space. So for this, thank you.
You're welcome. And I mentioned before, there's so many times I've said no, and I've had to say no to people over the last 18 months, and it was to get the courage I needed within myself also to decide to reopen, because there were so many reasons, and it's not such a simple thing to know how you feel about anything until you actually take action and you do it. So literally a week after I decided to say yes to reopening, in my own mind, in my own heart, you know, you turned up and other people have turned up also to use the holistic gardens. So the timing was really, really amazing for that. And the things that turned up, the opportunities that turned up. So the voice is something that everybody has. But as you say, the instrument, your body, and body I think is so important now for us to be really aware of how we can change. It's okay.
That's water.
The cat wouldn't drink it.
We have a problem.
But you know, it's the body is so important to be grateful for and be. I think we're all more aware of how health and being so lucky to breathe and, you know, the nature of what's around us for so long. So to be able to adapt again to the world, but to have a place where that can stay outside for a little while.
Absolutely.
And as you say, that joyful play, yet dimensions can be opened in your life, that new people. I mean, we've connected on a great way for the last 3 days, and it's effortless, and connecting with an instrument, I'm so excited about that. I'm looking now thinking, what's going to happen next? But I don't need to know what's going to happen next, because I trust you. So
it'll spoil the fun.
yeah, it's that, and like, you know, calling Ganesh in, and all of that, that's brand new to some people. I sing mantras of many different traditions, like you've mentioned. There is no rules, there's no rhythm, but it's one complete, you know, bring yourself into a whole existence. Yeah, it's enjoying your whole, everything you were allowed to do, to discover, to. So that is open here. And to go from being closed, not just to be open, but to be alive. And that's what I feel this course will bring. I feel it'll bring a lot of life, and you know, air energy is so expansive, and that's just great to have, you know. It's great to have as your first out of the traps, out we go. So thank you.
Please come. Please come. And there's also one element what I said, like about the body as being the instrument. So absolutely, and it's for me, it's not about your voice only, because your voice needs to have a clear body and clear conduit to be able to really achieve its full potential. So for the voice and for this instrument to be healthy, there are so many aspects of it. So there is our physicality and the way we move, the way we exercise, the way we dance, the way we practice our body on a daily basis is very important. That will be part of the training. How we find the space inside which is safe and sacred, and also where is this space? Sometimes we never got a chance to actually discover the space within, and this is where meditative techniques are coming very, very handy, which will be part of the course. And also afterwards we have the aspect which is the energetic aspect of our body, so the subtle way of how we work with the resonance. We will be exploring this as well. And then with that, things which will come very handy is the Western understanding of our health, so the tradition a lot of us come, Eastern tradition, which is coming from the Indian culture, which I'm also very connected to, with yoga and practicing different types of yoga, and also traditional Chinese medicine, which is a very Taoist way of looking at the world, which comes very, very handy in our complex way of understanding the life as well. So we're going to merge all of that, and we're going to play with all those traditions, all this wisdom, and each one of you will bring their own unique wisdom, and together we will use all this experience, every single body, every single instrument, to just create something together and play together the harmony which will happen. And this is something also harmony which will happen, but also bearing in mind the unique and sometimes very difficult situation we're in, you know, like with the things outside happening as well. So respecting that also. And
yeah.
And also like here as well, like within the space, it's this is something important for me, Eva. I really take care of the health and safety, and really looking after the equipment and the regulations as well. And
yeah, absolutely, yeah. So while we can retreat into this safe space, we're still people coming from the outside in, and you know that can be even on your inner journey too. The respect, you know, we have for our bodies, and you know that respect you have for your own body, you know, will filter out to everybody else. So it goes without saying on our behalf that we part of that safety, part of that base chakra and the grounding that comes here is the protocol we follow is what we've been given. As I said, I've never done pandemic before. I hope I don't do pandemic again, but it certainly is a conscious, collective consciousness that we go on for that criteria. So myself and Camilla have spoken about this. Everybody's ability to respond is, you know, the responsibility they have themselves. So we will be endorsing anything that Camilla does in questions about, you know, the COVID-19 situation, and whatever you bring in, we work together on that. But we certainly here will be maintaining the safety and the space to the hygiene that we hope will be satisfactory for everybody, but you know, that's the situation we're in, and that will be how we'll adapt and how we'll work together.
And this is something that will be of a huge benefit for each of you as well, because when we go through a time of a big transformation and huge shift and change, everything within us changes as well. So when we learn to expand at this time our boundaries and really learn to create a little safe space for ourselves to be able to integrate the process of change within us, then we go from the space where we are held completely and supported and everything is prepared for us during the course of the training, but then we go into our families, our friendships, our work and everything, and we are still having a safe environment to continue the process in a very mindful, steady, steadfast and also healthy way. So this transformation and the change does not have to be a healing crisis. It can be quite a steady, very balanced, really really held process for everyone, and that would be my intention for this training, to really offer this safe space for everyone in the times when we need it most.
Yeah, and just going back to the mantra, we practice. The sound of your voice can often be a red flag to how you have some part of your body that isn't feeling okay, and whether it's on an emotional, mental, or physical level. That daily practice you've spoken about that we will.
This is so timely for the times now, because like even with the virus, like what it affects is our lungs. So the source of the breath and the source of the sound, you know, that's how we make sound. We need the lungs and the respiratory. So the sound is amazing, and the humming techniques and ways to clear the sinuses and ways to clear your body is like so handy. And I would like to actually offer a little bit of sound.
Great.
Right now.
Yeah.
For that, and just see how it resonates. To finish our beautiful interview.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Eva, and thank you everyone for joining us. If you resonate with it, see you soon. Namaste.